There is nothing wrong with your television. Do not attempt to adjust the picture. We are now controlling the transmission. We control the horizontal and the vertical. We can deluge you with 1,000 channels or expand one single image to crystal clarity and beyond. We can shape your vision to anything our imagination can conceive. We will control all that you see and hear. You are about to experience the awe and mysteries from the deepest inner mind to the outer limits.
Now to me, O Thoth. Do I seek into thee in the ways of thy own words? Listen now, as I speak to thee of who I am, and from where I come, long ago, beyond the ages of the stars, before the brothers of the light and darkness began their conflict, before the light was set into place in the heavens, did I dwell in the space beyond space, in a time when nothing held form, or shape nor had the light even first formed, did I dwell in the eternal night. There in the darkness was the one who is of the all, and I, together. Within the one of all rose the divine flame, and from him I came forth the light of the mighty thunder. Together the might of my power collided with the flame of the all in one, and brought forth the first light within the heavens. His hands and mind set the stars into place and began the first motion of all things that ever will or ever could be into formation. The conflicts of these brothers are but pebbles within our mighty rivers. The things that cause and the things that are affected by the cause, which in turn spin the wheel of destiny in all things great and small, do not stand as obstacles before me or the All-in-One. Yet we do seek the aid of those within the realm of the mortals from time to time to act in ways we instruct them to sow, that they may be saved from tragedy and to free them from the bondage of their own making and that not of their making. For to guard those in the mortal realm from these things only makes certain that this place we have made in space and through time becomes shaped as we had intended. So know thee, O child of Atlantis, that I am not only a son of the light, but a child stars from which my seed was first planted, a starseed child capable of moving the stars and planets by sheer will of the mind. Yet I ever am a seeker of wisdom, just as you. I thank you for revealing these things to me. So in reward, I shall reveal to you the nature of my being. Know that we have met when you were given the wisdom to travel the halls of Amenti, the master who came before you bearing the book from which your wisdom had come. The man who was like a large wind carrying the souls of the seven masters and gave to you the secret of secrets that set them on their path towards the ultimate goal was me, the ascended master who exists in a time that has yet to be unfolded to you, the one they shall come to call Horus, for he is I and I am he.
The ancient key of magic listened closely. O mortal, to the ancient wisdom of magic, pay heed to the knowledge of long-forgotten powers. In the days of the first man, a great war began between darkness and light. Men, then and now, are filled with both darkness and light. And while some are consumed by darkness, others are illuminated by the light within. For ages upon ages, this eternal struggle between darkness and light has raged on. Fiercely, it is fought throughout time, using mysterious powers hidden from humanity. There have been adepts who embrace the darkness, constantly battling against the light. But there are also those who are filled with brightness, always conquering the darkness of night, no matter where you find yourself in the vast expanse of time and existence. You shall surely encounter the battle with darkness. Long ago, the sons of the morning descended upon a world enveloped in darkness. It was then that the timeless battle between darkness and light began. In that era, many were so consumed by darkness that only a faint glimmer of light shone through. There were those who mastered the darkness, seeking to engulf everything in their shadow. They desired to lure others into their night. Yet there were brave souls who fiercely resisted, fighting from the depths of the darkest night. They sought to break the chains that bind humanity to the darkness of night. Always did the masters of darkness employ dark magic, a power bestowed upon them by the darkness itself. This magic cloaked the souls of men in darkness, enslaving them and keeping them bound. United as the Brothers of Darkness, they have opposed the children of men throughout the ages. They walked among us, hidden and secretive, found yet unseen by humanity. Silently, they used their power, enslaving and restraining the souls of men. Unseen, they came and went, while ignorant men summoned them from the depths below. The path of the Dark Brothers is shrouded in darkness, not the darkness of night, but a darkness unknown. They traverse the earth, walking through the dreams of men. They have gained power from the darkness that surrounds them, summoning beings from other realms in ways that are hidden and concealed from humanity. They reach into the realm of human consciousness, enveloping it in their veil of darkness. Thus, the soul remains in bondage, chained by the shackles of the night's veil. Their knowledge of forbidden secrets is mighty. Forbidden because it is intertwined with the darkness. Listen, O wise elder, and take heed of my warning. Do not surrender your soul to the Brothers of Darkness. Keep your gaze always fixed upon the light. Do you not realize, O mortal, that your sorrows are a result of the veil of the night? Yes, man, pay attention to my warning. Strive always upwards. Turn your soul towards the light. The Brothers of Darkness seek out their brethren, those who have walked the path of light, for they know well that those who have journeyed closer to the sun, along the path of light, possess the power to bind the children of light with darkness. Listen, O mortal, to the one who approaches you, but carefully weigh his words to determine if they come from the light. For there are many who walk in a deceiving brightness, yet are not the true children of light. It is easy to follow their path, easy to be led astray by their guidance. But, O mortal, take heed of my warning. Light can only be attained by those who strive for it. The path that leads to wisdom is arduous. The path that leads to light is difficult. You shall encounter countless obstacles along your journey, mountains to climb towards the light. Yet know this, O mortal, those who overcome shall be liberated from the path of darkness. For, you see, in the end, light shall conquer, banishing darkness and night from its realm. Listen, O mortal, and embrace this wisdom. Just as darkness exists, so does the light. When darkness is banished, and all veils are lifted, the light shall burst forth from the darkness. Just as the dark brothers exist among men, so do the brothers of light. They stand as the adversaries of the brothers of darkness, seeking to free humanity from the clutches of the night. They possess mighty and potent powers, knowing the laws that govern the planets. They work in harmony and order, liberating the souls of men from the bondage of night. They, too, walk secretly and hidden, unknown to the children of men. They have eternally fought against the Dark Brothers, conquering and being conquered, without end. Yet in the end, light shall always prevail, dispelling the darkness of night. Know, O mortal, that always by your side walk the children of light. Masters are they of the radiant power of the sun, unseen, yet ever watchful guardians of humanity. Their pathway is open to all, to those who choose to walk in the illuminating light. They are free from the clutches of the dark realms, unbound by the dominion where life reigns supreme. Like shining suns, they are the lords of the morning, children of light, sent to shine among mankind, similar to us, yet different, never divided in their eternal unity, for they have existed as one in eternal oneness throughout all space since the dawn of time. They ascended from the first creation, from the formless and unformed realms. They have bestowed upon humanity the secrets that safeguard and protect us from all harm. He who desires to tread the path of the enlightened must liberate himself from the chains of darkness. He must conquer the shapeless and formless fears and triumph over the illusory specter of dread, knowledge. He must acquire the secrets, embark on the journey that traverses the darkness, yet always keeping the light of his goal before him. Great obstacles shall litter his path, but he must persist towards the brilliant light of the sun. Listen closely, O human, for the sun symbolizes the light that illuminates the end of your journey. Now I shall grant you the ancient wisdom, known only by the masters, the knowledge that conquers all fears of darkness. Utilize this wisdom I bestow upon you, and you shall become a master among the brothers of night. When a feeling draws you closer to the gates of darkness, examine your heart and question whether this feeling originates from within your own being. If you discover that darkness is born from your own thoughts, banish them from the recesses of your mind. Send a wave of vibration through your entire being, at first irregular, then gradually becoming rhythmic, repeatedly, until you feel liberated. Initiate the flow of energy in your mind. Direct it in waves from your head to your feet. But if you find that darkness does not stem from within, be aware that an external force is influencing you. Only through knowledge can you overcome it. Only through wisdom can you hope to attain freedom. For knowledge brings wisdom, and wisdom begets power. Acquire it, and you shall possess power over all. Begin by seeking a place enshrouded in darkness. Create a circle around yourself. Stand tall within the circumference, and employ this formula, for it shall set you free. Raise your hands to the dark expanse above you. Close your eyes, and draw in the radiant light. Call upon the spirit of light through the fabric of space and time, using these words, and you shall be liberated. Fill my body, O spirit of life. Imbue my being with the essence of light. Come forth from the radiant flower that pierces through the darkness. Come from the divine halls where the seven lords reign, I name them individually, the seven, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight, nine. By their names, I summon their aid to liberate me, to save me from the clutches of the night, Antanas, Quirdus, Cheadle, and Goyana, Hurtle, Semvedordle. By their names, I beseech thee, release me from darkness, and fill me with light. Understand, my friend, that when you accomplish this, you shall break free from the chains that bind you, shed the shackles imposed by the brothers of the night. Do you not perceive that these names possess the power to liberate through the vibrations they emit? Utilize them when needed to release your fellow beings so that they too may emerge from the depths of darkness. You, my fellow human, are your brother's helper. Do not let him remain captive in the clutches of the night. Now, I bestow upon you my ancient magic. Take hold of it and walk the path of light. May light guide you. May life nourish you. May you become a radiant sun in the cycles above.
Lord Zeus,
you grow stronger as your journey continues. But if you are to succeed in your quest, you will need my aid. I offer you the power of the greatest of all the gods, the Father of Olympus. I offer you the power of Zeus. Take this weapon, take this power, and use it to defeat your enemies. You have done well. Go with the gods. Go forth in the name of Olympus.
Constant exchange of energy. An infinite cycle of creation and destruction. Celestials use energy gathered from host planets to create suns, generating gravity, heat, and light for new galaxies to form.